welcome to the 12 days of Podmas and our wonderful New Year's Day treat with one Mr. Simon Lupton. Hello.
Hello. Happy New Year.
And one Ms. Sooz Kempner. Hello.
Hello. Happy New Year. Yay. 2022. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be nothing but good times.
Did you have a sober New Year's Eve or a very drunken New Year's Eve?
Drunk.
Yay! It's the best kind of New Year's Eve. all right, so we've got a very simple thing that we're going to look at today for this very special... What is it, Producer Sam? Is it the sixth day of Podmas?
Oh, now you're asking me to do maths. around that.
Eighth day of Podmas.
Yeah, that sounds right.
We're going to ask one of the biggest questions that we could think of in terms of what to ask about Queen. So here it is, guys. Seatbelts on. Freddie Mercury with a moustache or Freddie Mercury without a moustache?
Ooh, how long have we got?
How long do you need?
To discuss this?
Yeah.
Hours.
Okay. No one's doing anything else. Everyone's hungover. So they can listen to us talking about moustaches for an hour. Well, I'll tell you what, Sooz, you'll have a good sense of it. Where do you start? Where do you begin with...
Where do I stand on a moustache?
Yeah.
Carefully, on the edge. Hee-hee-hee. Ha-ha-ha-ha. The photos that I used to see of Freddie Mercury when I was a kid were with a moustache. So that's the iconic Freddie look for me. Mm. But he actually only had that tash for like 6 or 7 years, didn't he? But it has become the iconic Freddie look. I think it's because that's the look he was sporting at Live Aid that is Queen's most famous performance. Even if you hardly pay attention to Queen, you know that Live Aid performance. So I'm going to say with moustache, even though it was actually only a few years.
You're right. It was not just Live Aid. It was Wembley. It was... It was their stadium fame, like their
It was their 80s. Their 80s live era was all stash.
But do you think he looks better with the moustache?
Oh, Freddie looks great. However, his face is behaired.
Not bad with a beard, is he?
No.
Not bad with a beard on a train hurtling through walls. Very good stuff. All right, so it is New Year's Day, and we have the opportunity to ask the mighty John Robbins himself. John, where do you stand?
The thing is, with that no moustache, you also get sort of miracle and innuendo era Freddie, and I think he looks very cool in the video for Invisible Man.
Yes!
That's probably my favourite no tash Freddie. However, I think my least favourite Freddie look is circa sort of late-ish 70s, Somebody to Love, where he had that hair that was neither short nor long.
It's just big.
You know, sort of News of the World, it was just sort of big sort of hair. So that's a negative to the tashless Freddie.
Sure.
And the tash is just so interesting because of the way it was interpreted differently sort of in America to over here, the different connotations it had, sort of Freddie finding a very specific image. I like also how, even though it's very iconic, it enabled him to sort of blend in a bit more in the scene that he was into. So in a sense, it was like, it also anonymized him a bit off stage. So I think there's just a lot of factors, but I'm going to go for Tash.
Yeah, baby, of course you are. Good choice, John. Thank you very much. How about you, Mr. Lupton? Have you calmed down and made a choice?
Yes, I think I'm ready. Sue's absolutely right. When you think of Live Aid, that is how Freddie, I think, has become immortalised. That sort of Live Aid and Wembley 86, Budapest sort of look. And also, the outfits that... The whole band was sort of wearing around that time are sort of quite timeless. They're sort of like classic looks. So even though that is now 40 years ago, nearly, between 30 and 40 years ago, that sort of period, It still looks very real, very present, very now. When I look at Freddie sans moustache, it's usually accompanied by long hair as well. So that, to me, sort of dates it more back in the 70s. And I think I look at them at Queen and what the outfits they're wearing, what they were looking like in videos, and it feels more dated. So I think I prefer with moustache because it feels more timeless. And that, whenever anyone mentions Freddie, that is the image of him that pops into my head with moustache. Mm-hmm.
Do you know what? You're right. It's a deeper question than I think I realised.
Yes.
There isn't, because you're right, there's the 70s look, and it's dated to the 70s look. For me personally, the very first time I discovered that Freddie had a period without a moustache, I was upset by it at that age, right? I was like, what is happening? Who is this person? Why? Why, Fred? But thank God he grew that moustache, because I love it. I think it's the best moustache in history. I think we've discussed that before. The other thing about the not moustache is he had looks during the moustache period and post moustache period where he wouldn't have the moustache. So, say, I'm thinking of that moment with the ballet in the I Want to Break Free video.
Yeah.
Anything actually post A Kind of Magic. So, The Miracle and the Innuendo, he'd lost the moustache for both of those. And what's interesting when I think of that Freddie sans moustache, I always just think of him as absolutely beautiful. He's got these beautiful Persian cheekbones that all come out. Whereas sort of the 70s Freddie was beautiful, but kind of awkward with the big hair and everything, like you're saying. When he got that moustache, he just became so sexy to me. and then the periods in that where he didn't have the moustache, he was also really sexy or just beautiful. I mean, even if you're looking at sort of a couple of the music videos in the Innuendo period where, you know, obviously he was suffering by that point, but he was still, there was a beauty to him and an elegance. And I don't think it is as easy an answer as we may think. In fact, Emily Redman has asked us an interesting question that might help us with this. She asked, do you have a favourite 70s outfit or 80s outfit from any live gig or any member? But let's look at Freddie for this one, given we're talking about the moustache. Or do you have one in mind that you would, despite the fact that it's Queen in the 70s, describe as too ridiculous even?
I always loved the black and white Harlequin unitard that he used to wear. Yes. I used to think, when I was about 15, I used to go, be amazing if I had one of those. I could wear that. I mean, that would have been... I don't feel like that anymore.
Okay, if you could have one Freddie outfit, what would it be?
Oh, the Hot Space, that jacket with the arrows on it.
Oh, the arrows! Oh!
Yeah, I always want that jacket.
That's a good choice. Yeah. How about you, Simon?
I really liked the I Was Born to Love You video outfit.
Oh, yeah.
The all-in-white stuff with all the buckles and
lovely. Stuff.
And he has sort of like the braces that would, That was a good.
That was good. I think, if I'm absolutely honest, I think it's right on the tail end of the 70s. It might be right at the beginning of the 80s. But it is those tighty whitey shorts.
They're tiny shorts.
Every time, like the first time I saw that, it blew my mind that someone was walking around on stage in front of thousands of people in that. And every time now, if I think about it, it just makes me giggle. I love it. Well, shall we see what social media has decided?
Yeah, go on.
Have they decided? Freddie...
What do we think it's going to be? Do we think it's going to be 50-50? Do we think it's going to be Freddie Sons?
60-40 in favour of Tash.
Good choice. Yeah, is that you were on time? Okay.
That's my prediction.
Producer Sam. Well, the results.
So we put a poll out on Twitter. Very simple question.
Right.
Fred with the moustache or without it?
Yep.
Sooz is bang on.
No.
59.3% with moustache, 40.7% without.
Wow.
An overwhelming majority is in favour of the moustache. The moustache is the will of the people.
The people have spoken.
Yes. The people have spoken. It is Freddie with moustache. Well, I feel like this was time well spent.
Well, I do, but I hope the people listening to it also feel the same.
I don't think
they do.
We could be sure.
I can hear them.
You can hear
them? They're saying, wow, what a way to kick off the new year.
Yeah. 2022.
Great stuff. Thanks, guys. Yeah. See you soon.
Glad we got that one sorted.
Yeah. Let's start out the road to recovery on the right foot.
That's right.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year.
We'll see you all soon.
Bye.
This has been a Queen Pod Podmas special. A Seven Seas Films production, edited and produced by me, Sam Easton. Check out our Facebook, Twitter and Instagram for all things Podmas, and stay in touch by emailing queenpod@thequeenpodcast.com. Happy Podmas, and see you tomorrow. Traveling at the speed of light, I wanna make a supersonic man out of you. Stop me now, I'm having such a good time.